serious infections causing the anemia. Okay, that is itself a question and important to remember. That's why I will tell you some mnemonics for this particular one. Okay, the first of all is iron deficiency anemia. Okay, this iron deficiency anemia is done by these three important organisms, which are mainly the parasitic ones. T is Treacherous trichiura, which is also termed as what, whipworm, and the egg of it is having what, mucus plugs. S, that is Schistosoma, different species of it, and this is also termed as what, bilharziosis. And the H is what, the H is hookworm. Okay, H is hookworm, which consists of two. One is Ankylostoma and one is Nicator americanus. So these are the three important ones which you need to focus upon in causing up the iron deficiency anemia. Okay, so these particular three names you need to remember of regarding the iron deficiency anemia, that is TSH. And how to remember this? You will remember like this, that if you are going for the testing of iron, then there itself you will go for what, TSH testing also, that is Treacherous trichiura, Schistosoma species and hookworm. Okay, now talking about those particular ones which undergoes and cause hemolytic anemia, and for them you remember a mnemonic, that is BBC, England, में है. ओके, बीबीसी इंग्लैंड में है, एज सच है भी वही. फाइन, सो दिस इज देयर. बी इज व्हाट, बी इज बेबेसिया, बेबेसिया माइक्रोटी, व्हिच इज हैविंग व्हिच टाइप ऑफ क्रॉस, माल्टेज क्रॉस. अनदर बी इज बार्टोनेला. ओके, व्हिच बार्टोनेला, बार्टोनेला बैसिलिफॉर्मिस. ओके, बार्टोनेला बैसिलिफॉर्मिस व्हिच लीड्स टू दिस Varroa pariona or Perivan bot, fine. Then this particular C is Clostridial species, and in this Clostridial species also, which one? That is the Clostridium perfringens. Okay, Clostridium perfringens, that is there in that. Okay, E is Epstein-Barr virus infection. Okay, Epstein-Barr virus infection, and which is the most important one here, guys, that is the infectious mononucleosis. M is malaria, okay, done by the Plasmodium. And the H is, you remember these two, that is the hepatitis A. So these all are there, which leads to what, hemolytic anemia. BBC England mein hai. So that will easily make you remember regarding the various which causes this hemolytic anemia. Okay. Now talking about the megaloblastic anemia. The megaloblastic anemia, that is mainly done by a particular cystode termed as what, Diphyllobothrium latum. Diphyllobothrium latum, which is also named as what, fish tapeworm. And how does it does this megaloblastic anemia? By decreasing of the vitamin B12 absorption. Okay, now finally we can talk about the aplastic anemia. Okay, that aplastic anemia is done by what, and for this particular one you remember the mnemonic, aplastic only, in which definitely some of them will miss out, but still you will get a hint to remember the organism name. So A is just the anemia, it is not having any organism name. Fine, so just remember up, this is for the anemia. Which anemia? Aplastic anemia. Okay, so this A and this A, they are for this thing only here in this particular mnemonic. P is Parvo B19, and you clearly know that in sickle cell ones, this Parvo B19 does what? This aplastic stuff, aplastic crisis. Okay, then L is Leishmania Donovani, which leads to Kalazar. Okay, then this A is just for the same aplastic anemia stuff. S is also to be remembered as if in the mnemonic itself. T you can remember as tuberculosis. Okay, TB, then the mycobacterium tuberculosis. I is infectious mononucleosis. Okay, I is what? Infectious mononucleosis done by whom? Done by the Epstein-Barr virus infection. Epstein-Barr virus infection. And C, this particular C is, you remember like this, hepatitis C. Okay, hepatitis C. Hepatitis A was doing what? That was doing a hemolytic anemia. And this is hepatitis C, which is doing what? Aplastic anemia. Okay, so aplastic anemia hai, like this, you remember up. And from this H, you can get whole lot of things. Okay, from this H, if you go in a sequence, you will have lot of things like HHV 3, 4, 5, 6. All of them, they can associate with what? This particular aplastic anemia. Now, no points in guessing. You tell me HHV 3, what is the other name? That is varicella zoster. 4, we have already discussed up. That is Epstein-Barr virus causing one. That is Epstein-Barr virus causing what? Infectious mononucleosis, cytomegalovirus, and this is named as HHV6 only, fine, which leads to exanthem subitum. That also you need to focus upon. Okay, along with that, you can add up one more, that is the HIV from this particular H, and hepatitis C is remembered here itself, so you will not have difficulty to remember the hepatitis C as the causal agent of what? Doing aplastic anemia. So these are the various agents which leads to various types of anemias, right from the iron deficiency, which is there at TSH, then you have this BBC England mein hai, then diphyllobothrin letum, and then this mnemonic, that is the aplastic anemia hai. And this H is the most important because it is having right from 3 up to the 6 along with the HIV. Okay, a short question,